Hi everyone, today I want to talk to you about something you might find a little technical, but it's very crucial in understanding map projection. That's right, I am talking about UTM grid scale factor. So what is a scale factor? Simply put, it's a factor to convert between distances on the actual ground and the distances on a map. Let's dive into it a little deeper. UTM coordinate system divides the Earth into 60 zones, each 6 degrees of longitude wide. Here is my projected grid surface in the blue and ellipsoidal surfaces in light brown. Let me draw two lines perpendicular to ellipsoid, which is also intersecting the grid surface. Distance between A and B, or the spheroidal or ellipsoidal distance, will be greater than A dash to B dash, or the grid distance. But if we go outside of the zone, then the grid distance will be greater. This is because of the scale factor that we have applied in the spheroid to convert the 3D shape into a 2D surface. Now, this is too much simplification. There are many other factors, but today we are trying to understand the scale factor only. Every zone has a central meridian, and the scale factor at the central meridian is 0.9996, and that also at the equator. And the scale factor at the boundary of the zone will be exactly 1. If you cross the zone and don't change the zone number, then your scale factor will be greater than 1 and will keep increasing as you go further from zone boundary. But we don't do that, do we? So as soon as you change the zone number and start going from the zone boundary towards the central meridian, your scale factor will keep on decreasing till you reach central meridian and your scale factor will be 0.9996. Simple, eh? Not so fast. There are a few complications. Let's try to discuss them. I promise I'll try to make it simple. Let's draw to measure distances on all the possible surfaces, from ground to horizontal distance to geodesy, sea level distances to ellipsoidal distance, and lastly, grid distance. They may not be in the same order. This is just for easy understanding. Let's draw radius of the Earth and topographic height from the ellipsoid. So the formula for ellipsoidal distance is horizontal distance multiplied by r divided by r plus h, where r is the radius of the Earth and h is the ellipsoidal height. Now this r by r plus h is also known as elevation scale factor, approximately. And most often, the grid scale factor and the elevation scale factors are combined to get the combined scale factor, or CSF. So if you want to find the grid distance, that will be ground distance multiplied by the combined scale factor. Remember, we are not talking about the map scale here, like 1:5000 or 1:10,000. This is about actual mathematical measurement and not cartography. The UTM grid scale factor is calculated using a complex range of formula that takes into account the distances from the central meridian, the latitude, and also the elevation. We'll have a look at the formula a little later. Let's look at another case where UTM grid scale factor is used in construction and engineering projects. Accurate measurements are crucial for these types of projects. When building a bridge, one of the critical factors to consider is the distance between the two support points or pillars. In our example, let's say the distance between the two pillars are 450 meters. Now, when it comes to designing the bridge slab, the engineer needs to know how much the distance on the ground differs from the distance on the map. And that's where the UTM zone scale factor comes in. The scale factor for the zone 43 is 0.9996 at the central meridian. So to determine the distance on the map between the two pillars, the engineer needs to multiply the ground distance of 450 meters by the scale factor of 0.9996. This gives us 449.82 meters on the map. Please note, I have not considered elevation scale factor here. This could be very important to have a combined scale factor when doing engineering works for construction projects. Now you might be thinking, what's the big deal between the 450 meters and 449.82 meters? And it doesn't seem so significant, does it? But when it comes to engineering projects, even the smallest difference can make a big impact. Let's now look at a formula by which we can determine the point scale factor of any given point. To determine the scale factor at 20 degree north and 73 degree east, you need to use the following formula. Phew, that was a long formula, right? I'll have the formula in the description for your easy reference, if you ever need it. So there you have it. I'm thankful that we have softwares that can calculate the scale factor and not me. I hope this video was informative and helpful. If you have any questions or comments, please don't hesitate to write them below. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video.